Hello, I'm Kamil Dudka from Red Hat. I work on static analysis of Red Hat Enterprise Linux, and in this talk I will present an innovative solution to dynamic analysis of RPM packages. The presented solution was developed as part of the Aufoware project, which means automation of formal verification. This is a quick introduction to analysis of code. Both static and dynamic analyzers are tools that help us to find programming mistakes, which we also call bugs. Static analyzers do not execute the code. They just look at the source code and tell us, hey, this is not going to work. Static analyzers can now be embedded into compilers. You probably know the static analyzer embedded in C-Lang or the recently introduced GCC-F analyzer. Then we have standalone static analyzers like CPP check or shell check, which are open source, or Caverity, which is proprietary. Unlike static analyzers, dynamic analyzers need to execute the code. They execute the code in a modified runtime environment to extract the properties we are interested in. They can also be embedded in compilers, like for example address sanitizer, thread sanitizer, and so on. These analyzers are usually easier to automate. Then we have many standalone dynamic analyzers, but in this talk we will focus on valgrind and strace. Valgrind is a tool for finding memory management bugs, while strace is a tool that records syscalls associated with a running process. So we know static and dynamic analyzers. Let's have a look at analysis of RPM packages. Static analysis of RPM packages is easy. We have a tool named csmock, which takes a source RPM package and returns a list of potential programming mistakes detected by static analyzers. csmock provides an interface for plugins. The small blue boxes in this picture are csmock plugins. Each of them is responsible for a single static analyzer. The plugin interface makes it easy to plug additional static analyzers as needed. But in this talk, we are focusing on dynamic analysis. So can we implement dynamic analysis plugins for csmock? The answer is yes, but it is not so easy as one would expect. Building a package is not sufficient to get results of dynamic analyzers. In order to get the results, we need to run the binaries that we have built. Luckily, modern RPM packages run tests during the build, so we would like to run these tests through dynamic analyzers. Here is an example with logrotate, which is a package that I maintain in Fedora. You can use the comments above to explore the spec file. There is a build section which specifies how the package should be built when we create binary RPM packages. What is even more important for dynamic analyzers is the check section, which specifies how the binaries should be tested after they are built. If we run the comments below, it will automatically build the binaries and run the test as it is instructed in the spec file. So we have an interface to execute the check section of RPM packages. Dynamic analyzers usually support tracing of child processes. So we can simply combine it together and dynamically analyze the whole RPM build process tree top down. If everything goes well, the binaries we are interested in will also be dynamically analyzed at some point. But is this a good solution to our problem? No, because this way we are dynamically analyzing also RPM build, bash, GNU make, and all the system provided binaries that get into our way. Consequently, it takes ages to complete, and we get a lot of reports unrelated to the RPM package being analyzed. So we need to do something better. And here comes the innovation. We can make RPM build produce binaries that will automatically launch a dynamic analyzer for themselves each time the binaries are executed. Thanks to compiler wrappers we developed originally for static analyzers, it is really easy as you can see in this example. The first line inserts a compiler wrapper into the search path in front of the real compiler. The second line makes the wrapper append a custom compiler flag, which is in fact a linker flag. Finally, the third line causes that all the binaries produced in the build section will run through valgrind when they are executed in the check section. This is exactly what we needed. How does it work? The core idea in my example was using a custom program interpreter. Let's quickly explain what a program interpreter actually is. I guess you know shebangs from shell or Python scripts. If we look at the first line of user bin yum, we can see hash exclamation mark followed by user bin python 3. This line tells the operating system which interpreter should be used to interpret the script. So when we run user bin yum, the system reads the shebang and executes user bin python 3, passing it user bin yum as the first argument. I believe this is well known. What could be more surprising is that binary executables on Linux also have a program interpreter specified in their header. When we build an RPM package natively, it produces binaries where an ELF interpreter is where the ELF interpreter is set to the system dynamic linker. However, we can also set a custom ELF interpreter when linking the binary. And that is exactly what I did in my example. I set a custom interpreter that took care of launching a dynamic analyzer each time the binary was executed. Our custom program interpreter is in fact a wrapper of the system dynamic linker. The wrapper is called csexec. We can use the csexec wrap cmd variable at runtime to specify a dynamic analyzer to use. If the variable is unset, the binaries are executed natively. In any case, csexec runs the system dynamic linker explicitly. Otherwise, csexec would end up in an infinite loop, recursively invoking itself. So if we execute our logrotate binary with custom ELF interpreter, csexec executes the system dynamic linker through valgrind, giving it path of the original executable as the first argument. This implementation detail is usually not observable by the test programs that we dynamically analyze. However, some test programs are sensitive to the value of argv0, so we needed to extend the system dynamic linker to take the --argv0 option in order to make this work properly. Similarly, some programs are sensitive to target of proc self-exe symlink, which unexpectedly points to the system dynamic linker in our case. So we needed to emulate calls of readlink to pretend the original target, which is the binary being analyzed. I think I have said enough of implementation details. Let's have a look at the results of our experiment. The main goal has been accomplished. We have no unrelated bug reports in the output. Of course, if the RPM package uses a buggy library that leaks memory, it can still be reported by valgrind. On the other hand, valgrind will not complain about memory leaks of bash or gnumake just because we use them to run the test programs. There is no observable performance impact of csexec itself. Of course, if we run test programs through valgrind, they run significantly slower in some cases, but there is not much we can do about it. csexec works well with commonly used testing frameworks, which means it does not make them fail just because we execute the test programs through csexec. We were able to successfully run the whole upstream test suite of GNU coroutils with CSExec only. If we enable valgrind, it causes some tests to fail because they are simply not designed to work with valgrind. For example, there is a test that verifies the count of open file descriptors. The problem is that valgrind uses some extra file descriptor for itself, which breaks the test. Another example is a test that intentionally sets a non-existing path as tempdir to verify error handling in the program. Unfortunately, this also prevents valgrind from starting, which in turn results in artificial failure of the test. Now back to csmock, the tool originally developed for static analysis of RPM packages. We have implemented experimental plugins for valgrind and strace. These plugins are now available in Fedora and EPL. Thanks to these plugins, dynamic analysis of RPM packages is now available through a really simple user interface. You can just pick a source RPM package that runs tests during the build and throw it at csmock together with a build route where the package can be built. Optionally, you can specify some extra arguments for the dynamic analyzers. I think that now is the time for a quick demo. Hopefully you can see my terminal. I will get a source RPM of the latest build of Logrotate. I can use the Koji client for this task and the Koji download build command. So I have the source RPM package, so I can just give it to csmock, enable the valgrind plugin and specify the build route. And that's all. csmock will now run fully automatically and give us the results from valgrind on the run of the upstream test suite. You probably know the mock tool for building RPM packages. csmock is very similar. The only difference is that csmock does not produce any binary packages. It just gives us the list of potential bugs in the package. And it seems to take slightly more time than expected, so I will pause the recording for a moment. Sorry for the gap. My home office connection is too weak to download all the dependencies of Logrotate in a reasonable time. But now it seems to progress. We can see that valgrind is being downloaded and installed into the build route. csmock then applies some workarounds for broken packages, which we sometimes need to deal with. Now it installs csdiff into the build route. It is a tool that can recognize the output of various static analyzers and, for example, compare a pair of old and new builds and give us the difference. Now csmock is copying some files into the build route, which are needed to drive the analysis. And now the build of LogRotate is finally starting. If I look correctly, yeah, this is the build section. We can see the autoconf checks running. As you can see, the build runs as fast as it would run natively. So the build is complete. And now finally the check run of the check section is starting. At first glance, the output looks as usually. It is just a bit slower because all invocations of LogRotate are wrapped by valgrind, which is not visible in this output. If you are wondering why the test numbers are mixed up, it's because the tests run in parallel. It means that valgrind also runs in parallel. So if we use a multi-core CPU, we get the results faster. As you can see, some test cases take slightly longer to complete if they run through valgrind. We can use this time to have a look what happens behind the scene. Let me increase the font. So this is the process tree of csmock, where we can see the build and the test suite. Again, it looks as if the build ran natively. The only difference is the valgrind here at the leaf processes. We can see that only one instance of valgrind is running. So this seems to be the most expensive test case of LogRotate. It has already consumed more than a minute of machine time. So let's wait slightly longer for it to complete. We can see that we ask valgrind to produce XML output, which is better if it needs to be machine readable than the default output. And I think it has finished, so we can switch back. Now we can see that csmock picks the results out of the build root and runs some final cleanup to save disk space. So let's give it a second to complete, and we got the results. So we can unpack the results archive, and we can see some files from captured by valgrind. There is one file per a process annotated by its PID. So we can have a look at arbitrary one. Let's take this one. We can see the captured XML file. And if we look here, we can see that the report is really about the LogRotate binary. So we can have a look what happened. Some memory was leaked by LogRotate. So now we can analyze the backtrace provided by valgrind. Let me switch back to my presentation. There is a more detailed demo available at the URL below if you are interested. Although the presented solution works fine, there is still some room for improvement. There is a work in progress patch for CSDiff to parse valgrind's XML output. The goal is to present valgrind's results in a similar way as we present the results of static analyzers. Developers are used to reports pinned to source code rather than PID-oriented reports about processes that do not exist anymore. We could also port CSExec to more architectures. For now, CSExec runs on 64-bit Intel only. It is not yet supported to use multiple dynamic analyzers in a single run of csmock. This is going to be resolved by extending csmock to be able to run the check section repeatedly without a full rebuild of the package. The original motivation for this effort was formal verification of RPM packages, which we experiment with in the AuthAware project. AuthAware means automation of formal verification. It is a project supported by Technology Agency of the Czech Republic. We are going to develop csmock plugins to integrate formal verification tools, namely for Symbiotic, Divine and CBMC. Based on our experiments, the formal verification tools will be improved to handle more RPM packages. But this is a task for universities which develop the verification tools. That's all for me. Thank you for listening. I'm ready to take questions.